Next Tuesday, March 26th, the EU Parliament will take a last vote on the new EU Copyright Directive, a piece of legislation that has been heavily scrutinized and will fundamentally impact the way the internet is structured. Most controversial are Articles 11 and 13. Article 13 will change how platforms have to handle copyright-protected material. The current situation is that they have to delete copyright-protected material when the copyright holder makes a claim on it. The new directive will change that so that platforms are not allowed to ever have copyright-protected material uploaded on them, except with permission of the copyright holder. The problem with that is that the only practical way for larger platforms like YouTube to ensure no such material gets uploaded is through the use of upload filters. These filters will try to automatically determine if some content violates some copyright and only let content through that they are sure does not. Of course, the only way to ensure that content does not violate any copyright is to err massively on the safe side and filter out any content that looks even somewhat similar to copyright protected content. This is why in the past, when upload filters were used, they also filtered out a ton of content that was not at all copyright protected, like for instance a video of cats purring, because it kind of sounded like a passage in some song. Some companies are exempted from Article 13, but they have to fulfill all three of the criteria listed. Article 13 is so bad that it brought, among many others, some of which are mentioned later, YouTube CEO Susan Wojcicki, apologies if I mispronounce it, to speak out against it, the first time that she argued against the law in this way. Speaking directly to creators, she said, "This legislation poses a threat to both your livelihood and your ability to share your voice with the world, and if implemented as proposed, Article 13 threatens hundreds of thousands of jobs, European creators, businesses, artists, and everyone they employ. The proposal will force platforms like YouTube to prioritize content from a small number of large companies. The burden of copyright proof will be too high for most independent creators to instantly demonstrate. There's a better way forward for copyright online, but it's critical you speak up now." Apart from the difficulties for creators, the infrastructure forced into place by the new law can then be easily abused to enforce automatic censorship of controversial material, like videos about politics. Politicians of the CDU, the German center-right party, which had a large hand in creating this law, have made some statements about how they would not use upload filters to enforce it, but instead create some period in which copyright-protected videos or videos which use copyright-protected content could exist without being liable, but afterwards they would have to pay royalties or something to that effect. These statements really showed me how they had no clue what's in the bill actually, because nothing they said made any sense within the law itself. It would be completely incompatible to the law itself, and it just shows that they have no clue about the bill. There's also Article 11, which gives publishers the right to claim royalties if more than single words or very small excerpts of any published articles are used. This is particularly meant to get Google to pay for the previews they show of news articles under their links. Two similar laws were implemented in Spain and Germany, with the result that Google just abolished Google News in Spain and Germany granted it an exception when it became clear that it would rather restrict its service than pay. The calculation behind Article 11 is that the EU itself might be big enough to force Google into submission, but Google has already signaled that this will not happen. The case of Germany is particularly illustrative. Google was big enough to force an exemption for it, while smaller companies have to abide by the new regulations. The Copyright Directive also contains some smaller curiosities, like Article 12a, which prohibits the publication of any pictures or videos of sports events except by the promoter. A funny detail showing the degree of competence that went into the creation of this bill is that Axel Voss, one of the driving forces behind it, was surprised when he heard about that and did not believe it was actually in there. A large number of individuals and companies have spoken out against the reform, including European Digital Rights, the Internet Archive, Patreon, WordPress, Medium, Jimmy Wales, the founder of Wikipedia, the the UN Special Rapporteur for Free Expression, the Max Planck Institute, and the ISPA, so the Internet Service Providers of Austria. Petitions, which are linked to below, as well as demonstrations and calls to the members of the European Parliament, have increased the pressure to such a degree that Axel Voss and Manfred Weber, the boss of the EPP, the European Centre-Right Party, tried to move up the voting day at the beginning of March, only to reconsider after their attempt was made public. I think this attempt really shows the public pressure getting to them, and hopefully them running out of votes. Right now, the European Parliament is especially sensitive to public pressure, because elections are coming up in May, and if this directive is implemented, the consequences, like for instance that content which is right now perfectly normal to stream on YouTube, will be blocked, that these consequences will mobilize swaths of the population which would normally not vote in European elections, and that this might negatively impact the vote tallies of MEPs who supported this bill. Initially, I wanted to do a live call in this video, so I wanted to call a Austrian MEP and just tell them that I do not plan to support them in the elections and just pressure them a bit if they vote for this bill. This is a bit of a fun way to pressure them, because then all their statements are online on YouTube and can be watched, which will further affect their reputation. But I was not able to reach a representative that would be interesting. I tried Harald Wileminski of the FPÖ and Heinz Becker of the ÖVP. The ÖVP directly voted for this bill. The FPÖ abstained from voting. And I think both are reasonable people to pressure. The FPÖ because Harald Wileminski, because he actually spoke out against upload filters, but then abstained from voting. And I think the reason is that the FPÖ has a bit of a dualistic approach to the internet. On the one hand, it helps them through portals like Unzensoriert, which is a far-right Austrian portal that is very supportive of the FPÖ, especially of the more right-wing part of the FPÖ, which Wileminski belongs to. And therefore, they have at least some sympathy for internet users. On the other hand, I'm pretty skeptical of just their commitment to free speech. So, but there might be some hope of swinging them around to voting no on the next elections, or on the vote for this bill, I mean. And pressuring the ÖVP, well, I'm not sure how much chances there are, but of course, if they would actually be swayed, which I still think is possible, because for instance Heinz Becker has spoken out about exceptions which should be in the bill, which he hoped would be implemented in further drafts of the bill, which have not been implemented. So if we hold him to his own statements, he should maybe vote against this bill. If we are able to sway those people, that would have a larger impact than swaying the FPÖ, which just abstained, while the ÖVP directly voted for the bill. Now, to their miscredit, the SPÖ also voted for the bill the last time this vote, a vote was coming up. But right now, due to I think public pressure and due to them realizing what it actually contained, they have committed to voting no this time around. All the other politicians, I think, voted no already the last time around. So the Greens in particular. As mentioned before, Jimmy Wales, the founder of Wikipedia, has spoken out against this bill. And Wikipedia itself will go offline for a day. I think it is Monday 25th. to express its discontent with this bill. There are, as far as I know, no further direct actions by the large players of the internet like Google and Facebook, but there are still a lot of demonstrations between now and the February 26th when the vote will be cast, and I can just urge you to attend them or to at least to sign petitions. And I think the most direct and best medium to express your discontent is just to call the MEPs who voted for the bill or abstained from voting for the bill last time around. Because you can actually reach the MEPs themselves. Some of them will actually call back. I already called some people of the SPÖ before they committed to, or before they said they committed to voting against the bill the next time around. And they were very supportive and helpful. And it was actually nice talking to them. And I really felt like they were at least open to discussing the reservations their constituency has regarding, for instance, this bill, but I think also other bills. It is amazing that we have these very open institutions where you can just call literally your MEP and tell them about your opinion and talk to them. And a lot of people don't know that. I myself didn't know that to this extent when before I called there. I just thought probably a secretary will talk to you and take note of your considerations or whatever, and then they will maybe like calculate that this many people called, so it is this bad for the next elections probably. But no, you can actually talk to them themselves, and some of them, not all of them, but some of them are actually pretty supportive. I want you to subscribe and click the bell. Also, I want your questions and your feedback. You can send them to me by Facebook, by Twitter, and by email. The links are below. Thank you for your time.